Don't hate on my guy OneNote, but you could just make something in Notion that's similar to OneNote. I know you might be saying, that's gratuitous. What's the point? All right, relations are a thing, and you can connect it to like tasks or projects. I don't know. There's something that can be done with it, and that something is worth the time. Because Notion, you're great. There's going to be a template in the description. Also, if you want me to build something custom for you or consult you on Notion, check it out in the description. Getting started, I'm going to make a little OneNote database and make it a full width page. Add some sort of cover to make it look nice. And then from there, we're going to make two columns. So luckily with the new update, you can do /col2. And I'm going to put notebooks here as an H3. And then below that, do a little... another H3 for databases, and I'm going to drag this to the side. So this is going to be sort of a synced header view. So what I'm going to do is select a block here, turn it into a synced block, drag these puppies into the sync block, and then in here, I'm going to make /page, and then I'm going to create a database called a notes database. This is using the basic principles that I talk about often in the TTP method, which is having this backend Earth database rather than having it showcase on your pages so that everything you interact with is a link view. So then what you want to do is go to the top right of this page, copy the link, paste this linked view of a database here. So usually how OneNote works is that you're going to have this sort of notebook system, where then there's different sections within it and then subsections. So I'm going to create that with linked databases and a synced header that's gonna blow your mind. So we go here, this is the notebook section. And what we're going to need property-wise to make this happen is a few things. So I'm gonna make a date property and then a created time for those who would want that. And then from a select property, we're gonna call one notebook. Then we're gonna make another select property called section. Then we're gonna make another one called page group. And we're just gonna put an example here and call this one school fall 2022. And then the sections, for example, could be different classes. So we can do marketing 405, and then we'll do another class be management 410. And then we'll get to page group examples. It would be lecture notes, and then another one could be homework. So then moving forward with this idea, this is sort of the main home page, right? So what you're gonna wanna do is copy this three dots, put it here, paste it, and link to page here. And you can make the next part of this, have this page be all. And what I would recommend is that you actually, on this main page, is first go and group this table by notebook. Then you'll see that you have the option to see the school fall 2022 notebooks in here. And then I could add another example notebook, which could be YouTube. And then I can organize this so that the no notebook ones are on the bottom. So I can give an example of lecture notes here, an example of a YouTube script here. And then once again, I can put page group here to scripts. And then in order to organize it better, we're going to want to make sure that the page group is at the end, as that is the lowest in the hierarchy. And I would maybe even clarify and say this is more Rise Productive as a general thing. And then section would be YouTube, and then the page group would be scripts. So then we could duplicate this view and change it from being grouped by the notebooks to group by something else. So we can group it by page groups. So you can group this by page groups. Then you could duplicate and group this by section. And the reason you're going to want to go through and group all these like this is because what's going to happen with the filtering side of things that'll happen in a second. And then make sure that you sort it based off of your preference, whether it be the date or the created time. So I'm going to go through and make all of this sorted by created time. So then what I would recommend that you do is you go and you go one step out of it. So this is where my Notion templates are in the back end. And I'm going to essentially duplicate this page, put it back in here, drop this into the synced header, go into this, and then I want to change the naming conventions on this, right? So this is going to be for the specific notebook. So this would be school fall 2022. And I could change cover image to showcase this school, little cap action here. And then what you do is you'd go through and you'd filter this. Obviously for notebooks, you don't really want to keep this one because it's already understood that this is the notebook. But what we do is delete this. And then from a page group perspective and a sections perspective, I'm going to make sure we get the order right once again. So we want to make sure that the section is prior to that. And then, sorry, let's go back here and make sure this is organized better. So the sections are here and the page groups are under it. So what you do is you'd filter to where the notebook is school fall 2022. Save that. Filter notebook school fall 2022. And then grouping wise, you'd go through and hide the sections that aren't a part of the notebook that you're in. So then once again, if you go to the page groups here, we do the exact same thing. You go group, hide scripts. And then if you wanted to, we'd go here and duplicate this section. And then I would maybe even change this to a calendar view. And you can either calendar it by the created time or the date. So I'm gonna do created by the calendar, created time, and then the filter will remain. That is only that it's school fall 2022. So then here, if we went and looked through, we'll see that homework can be categorized. You can see what's for homework. And then what section is it in? Now you could obviously go through and hide the notebook since we already know that it is the notebook. And you can go through here and show properties that make more sense, like the page group and the section. And then even from here again, there is always the option to make it a board view. And then you could group by the section, hide out the ones that you don't want, and then subgroup by the page groups. And then you could hide out those as well. And you could obviously showcase the created time here or the date here, and it would sort by the ascending as we had before. And you can choose whether you want to have this lecture notes or homework in the subgroup higher or lower based off what you want. I would actually probably recommend that you make everything descending from a created time perspective so that the most recent things come up first, but it is up to your preference and I wanted to show you both options. But then in order to make another one like this, what you do so you just take this page, press duplicate, and then for me, I'd change it to Rise Productive, toss in my little favicon here, change the cover image, and then filter it all so that it would only showcase Rise Productive. And then for the board view and all the other views, I would make sure that I go through and I fix this so that I show this and then have the group be sections that only apply here. And then the exact same thing would apply for all of these subgroupings. So I'd go through, and all the ones that are hidden, I'd add. And then the same goes for this one as well. And then in order to cycle through both of these, I'd easily be able to go through and see the notes that I have for the different classes in order and cycle through the different types of notes as well, while having it only showcase what I need for the specific classes that I want. And then if I wanted to go through all of it, I could go back here. I could see all the notes that I have in these. And you could also make more sense of your Notion workflow by clicking right here. So you can improve your Notion even more.